Amazing! We're opening the treasure chest is open. Treasure chest is open.
Here's my claim. And I stand in front of everyone today with full confidence that this claim will not be refuted. There is no scientific evidence of God. Wait a minute. Now you're using too many words. Let me rewind. I want to learn. Which is a genetic fallacy, by the way. Discrimination and all of those things, which are axiomatic, otherwise unprovable. Here's what I'm saying to you. The point is this. I was born in London. Barbaric, outdated. And what happened was, I didn't get a choice. Did you get a choice? That you had to obey the law or not, or to be a citizen or not. I was just forced into the social contract. Freedom of expression and freedom of religious expression and freedom of thought and so on and so forth. All of that was curtailed at the very starting point for me. Some brothers are going to say, wait a minute. For example, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in a hadith in Bukhari, become liberal. The most bloody massacres in human history, and I say this with full confidence, have been perpetrated by liberal states. Now the question is this still applicable today? Now let's look at something else. Something which we don't need. And by the way, I was a history teacher in the UK for some time. Never did we teach this, and it wasn't even on the national curriculum. Many Muslims don't even know what happened in an Islamic state. Why? Because the French were adamant on censoring this information because it included rape, pillaging, of human beings. You know, I did some research, which I'm going to publish soon, inshallah, maybe a week or two. It's basically ISIS on steroids. Democracy is much older than Prophet Muhammad's time. And he mentioned it as outdated, as if some kind of argument. This is dysfunctionality in argumentation.
Yeah, this party's up. stay for a white wedding. It's a nice day to